post-Super Brawl press conference. Hi, everybody. I'm Tony Schiavone. Welcome back to Worldwide Wrestling. As always, for the next 60 minutes, you're ringside with the superstars of WCW World Championship Wrestling. This week, we will have the U.S. Tag Team Champions, Greg Valentine and the TaylorMade Man, against a team that once held those belts. Todd Champion, Chip the Firebreaker of the Patriots, a little bit later on in the hour. Our main event will be the Steiner brothers, Scott and Rick Steiner, still looking to get those World Tag Team belts from the Dangerous Alliance. They'll face two members of the Dangerous Alliance this week, the Cruncher Larry Zbyszko and one half of the World Tag Team Champions, Beautiful Bobby. Fans will also hear comments from Sting, as well as comments from the Dragon, Ricky Steamboat, and see footage of what transpired at Super Brawl a mere 2 weeks ago when Steamboat lost in his bid to become U.S. Heavyweight Champion. Our first match coming up on Worldwide Wrestling, fans, right after you see this timeout.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Macon, Georgia, weighing 235 pounds. He says he's the prettiest man in World Championship Wrestling, Johnny B. Bag. And his opponent from Tampa, Florida, 243 pounds, Rick Thames.
Rick Thames and Johnny B. Bad, as a fan gets a kiss that doesn't miss, and Johnny's still playing around out here in the ringside area. Boy, they love him, don't they? Certainly one of the most charismatic athletes we've had in a long time here at WCW. Someone's gonna get a shot at confetti. Oh! Johnny B. Bad. Well, fans, as you know, Flying Ryan regained the WCW Light Heavyweight title at Super Brawl a couple of weeks ago. And, of course, Johnny B. Bad is the man who's had an issue with Flying Ryan ever since Brian kind of smacked him on his rear end at one of our Clash of Champion events. Flying Ryan, Johnny B. Bad, two men who will be doing battle, I'm sure, very soon for that Light Heavyweight title. What a match it would be. The quickness of Flying Ryan, the quick left hand of Johnny B. Bad. Two men with supreme confidence and two men with a ton of ability. There's that left hand. He is so quick. A warning by Nick Patrick, the referee. Don't forget, as we said, fans, still to come, a look back at Super Brawl. What transpired between Steamboat and Ravishing Rick Rude for the U.S. Heavyweight title, plus comments from the Dragon himself. Some very, I might say, pointed comments as well. Tame sends Johnny in. Little crossing motion there, and he just kicked him right in the face. Oh, and he sends him down the clothesline. Johnny B. Up top. Sunset flip over the top. Fans know it's the left hand that he's showing. That's his primary move. Great elevation with a high back body drop. Here we go. Or do we? No, Thames. I guess he knows it's coming. He went back to the ropes. There's the high knee. And here we go. Look behind you. Oh, too late. Lights out.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, Johnny B. Bad.
Now he's got him going now, Johnny B. Bad, and the fans there gonna plan on the kiss that doesn't miss. Still to come, Rod Sidler, Jump Pistol Steve, right now, WCW this week.
Tony Schiavone will be back with more action on Worldwide in just a moment. Hello, everybody. I'm Eric Bischoff. My guest on WCW this week, Paul E. Dangerously, Larry, the Cruncher Zbyszko, and beautiful Bobby Eaton of the Dangerous Alliance. And Paul E. Dangerously, later on in the hour, the main event, the Steiner Brothers get another shot at the Dangerous Alliance.
You know, the Steiner Brothers have been crying and whining to WCW. We want another shot at Bobby and Arn. We want another shot at the World Tag Team titles. But you're not going to get another shot at the World Tag Team titles. So I'll tell you what we're going to do, Steiner Brothers. We're going to make it fair. The Dangerous Alliance will allow you to earn another shot at Bobby Eaton and Arn Anderson. I'll put half of the World Tag Team champions in the ring. I'll put Bobby Eaton inside the ring with you. And I'll also put Larry Zbyszko. And if you want one more shot at Bobby and Arn, there's only one thing you have to do. Get past the Cruncher.
You know, it's time for the crying to be over and the Steiner Brothers to grow up. Scott Steiner, no more standing around looking at your biceps saying, wow, my arm is big, but my brain is small. Is that why Rick Steiner has to wear the headgears to protect what brontosaurus brainage he has left? Take off the headgears, quit worrying about the biceps, and grow up and become real men. Because if you don't, you'll never beat the last two real men on the face of the planet, part of an extremely dangerous alliance.
Wrestling fans, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Wyoming, weighing 230 pounds, Young Pistol Steve.
One out of the Young Pistols. A lot of success in tag team wrestling for Steve. And there's no question, he has all the ability in the world. As he comes into the ring, set to go. One of our feature matchups this week on Worldwide Wrestling.
And his opponent from Warner Robins, Georgia. Weighing 278 pounds, the All-American, Ron Simmons!
Ron Simmons and Young Pistol Steve, no strangers at all. It was Ron Simmons and Big Josh who won the U.S. Tag Team belts from the Young Pistols, and of course, Greg Valentine and the TaylorMade Man turned around and won the U.S. Tag Belts from Simmons and Big Josh. So we are set to go. There's a Ron Simmons fan, number 50 at FSU. Member of the Atlantic Coast Conference now, by the way. As we're set to go in this event, Simmons, look for the power of Simmons to play a big factor in this, of course. Ron is not only, you know, we talked so much, and last week I interviewed Harley Race, and I talked about the power of Big Van Vader, maybe the most powerful man in WCW. There is a difference between power and strength. Power many times measures the force of your blows or your maneuvers with a lot of power. Strength, of course, is in the holds and the lockups, showing your strength. But there's no question that Simmons not only is strong, but with being able to push up like that, displays a lot of power, a lot of force, and a lot of those maneuvers he loves. A lot of the fans are giving the tomahawk chop. Of course, that maneuver and that sign from the fans, I guess we think of the Atlanta Braves, but it was originated with Florida State University and the Seminoles. Not going to knock him down at all. And Armstrong knows better than that. But he's showing Simmons he's not at all intimidated by his strength. And that's a power slam. Once again, to execute something like that, it doesn't necessarily take strength, which Ron has. It's just a power move. Ron's going to come at him. And Simmons on the attack. Simmons, there's no question, one of the greatest athletes of all time in our sport. Telegraph that one now. And the one great move by Steve has been a get out of the way type maneuver, a defensive maneuver. to Simmons. Head in the head now. And using the ropes, I can't catch with a warning. The warning and the break intact, but the damage has been done to the throat of Ron Simmons. Trying to take the stronger, bigger man off his feet. He puts him back up to a vertical base, though. Enabling Simmons for the sunset flip. We have a two count. A kick right on the back. Simmons, who has had his titles in tag team, U.S. and world tag team title, but certainly has been a man we've seen frequently in the top 10. The top 10 rankings of world championship wrestling. And you know, the top 10 is in itself very tough to break into.
Where's he at, folks?
Sting, the world heavyweight champion. Of course, the number one contender is always U.S. heavyweight champion, but the athletes we have at WCW weekly check the press releases by the WCW office to see where they stand in the top 10. It means a lot as far as money, prestige, and potential title shots are concerned. Steve, he went down to both knees, and as Ron came in to hit him, Steve got him with a headbutt right in the midsection. Now Steve to the Young Pistols, laying those right hands to the back of the neck. The Irish whip to the left side. He misses the clothesline. But Ron didn't miss that shoulder block. Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, the All-American, Ron Simmons.
To tell you when you are WCW World Heavyweight Champion, they come at you from everywhere. Rick Rude, Big Van Vader, and others. Standing by with comments, the one and only world champion, Sting.
I'm glad I get this chance to talk to everybody right now. I got something I want to say. For so long now, you've seen me beat on my chest. You've seen me howling. You've seen me high-fiving people at ringside. You've seen me pat the little kid, the little stinger with the spiked hair, just like this on top of the head. And you've heard me talk about goosebumps. You've seen me get excited. You've seen me literally run up into the stands right in the middle of a match. I got news for you. You combine all of that up into one big bundle, and that's exactly how I felt when this thing all of a sudden became mine, the Stingers. I've been here once before, and to have it again the second time blows away the first time. Lex Luger was a great opponent. And speaking of opponents, I know Paulie Dangerously and the rest of his alliance. Everybody wants a piece of it. Let's start at the top with the number one contender, and that's you, Mr. Swivelin' Hips, Rick Rude. Anytime you want it, I'm here. Come and get it. Woo!
Ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Introducing team number one, they are the United States Tag Team Champions. Introducing from Seattle, Washington, weighing 254 pounds, Greg Valentine. And from Vero Beach, Florida, weighing 236 pounds, the Feller Made Man.
The U.S. Tag Team Champions won the belts back on the 29th of February in a nationally televised match. And here 2 weeks later, there's still the chance to go back to Gary Petta.
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents from the WCW Special Forces, Firebreaker Chip, Todd Champion, the Patriots.
The Patriots, a team that literally stormed out of the scene, no pun intended, in World Championship Wrestling, became the U.S. Tag Team Champions. Belts, of course, they lost to the Young Pistols. And through a series of other events, now Greg Valentine and the TaylorMade Man, two veterans against two youngsters here. So it's going to be a classic case, if I could use that term again. I know it's overused, but I'll do her. A classic case of the veterans against the rookies.
And when you talk about veterans, Greg Valentine, one of the premier athletes in the sport, one of the all-time greats who has used primarily those big forearm blows that he got his nickname, the Hammer, from. But more than that, the figure four leg lock of Greg Valentine that we saw just last week executed on the Z-Man. Shoulder block. And I mean, he is nailing Chip in that corner. That's a place you do not want to be against Greg Valentine. A reversal. Chip, reckless abandon, but he stayed on his feet. Valentine tried to regain his senses. And I really think that that move by Chip wasn't that effective, because Valentine had got back to a vertical base. It was established, and he just kind of let the momentum take him over. Todd comes in. Valentine and Taylor now the U.S. Tag Team Champs. And of course, there is the issue. Z-Man and Marcus Alexander Bagwell have plenty of issues with Valentine and Taylor. We do understand that Valentine and Taylor will be putting those U.S. belts up on the line against Bagwell and Z-Man, and which should be a great match, not only because of the four athletes, but because of the animosity which is developed. Todd Champion, Gorilla Press now. And that was a youngster's mistake, not hooking the far leg. But he comes right back with his power. Of the two men, Todd Champion has a lot of strength. Chip has a lot of strength. So it's a very strong team. Taylor is more of a finesse wrestler, and Valentine, the strength, the power man of the group. So power-wise, strength-wise, it would have to go to the Patriots as a team. But Taylor has quickness, ring savvy. Oh, and there's the Hammer maneuver. And it caught Todd Champion on the mat. And it rocked the back of his neck. Valentine. Snapmare takeover. And the elbow on top of the head. Boy, when he gets you down, he knows how to hammer you in the mat, doesn't he? To the midsection. Champion slams Valentine down. Drops a leg. Out of it. Greg Valentine. It'll take more than a leg drop to keep Greg Valentine down. For the Patriots to pull what certainly would have to be considered an upset, it's going to take tremendous teamwork. But also, they're going to have to wrestle with tremendous confidence.
Hey, he's got the touch, man.
Valentine, who's a pro, does a lot to work on the confidence. Pick up. Atomic drop from the inverted position, and there's a... Actually, it wasn't a clothesline. He just really just took him by the chest and shoved him down. Taylor, the jawbreaker. That'll make you wish you had a mouth guard in. And now Chip trying to fight back. Taylor quickly jumps him on the outside. Oh, that time he went on the outside. He hit the steel barricade. You see him up against there. And here comes the great Valentine. Valentine. He can lay him in. Meanwhile, in the ring, the referee, Randy Anderson, with a warning to Todd Champion. And Champion, the inexperienced move that time, had the attention of the referee, enabling Valentine to get the illegal advantage. Taylor that time blocked. Not only he got Champion in, double team, you see on the other side what's happening. Well, and the Hammer comes in. Valentine covers. Good move that time by Chip to get out of it. He just slid his arms ahead, causing the break in the count. Vertical suplex. Two count. Valentine. Trying a vertical suplex. Chip is blocking. Fans are behind the Patriots. He got him up. All 254 pounds. up over his head, and Valentine quickly gets to the corner. Can Chip get there? He cannot, and Taylor cuts him off nicely. Chip Day swinging wildly. Gut wrench pickup into a power bomb, one of Taylor's premier moves. But the Patriot, Chip, nowhere out of this one. Got him up. We got a two count. Taylor, a high impact maneuver to the head. Hook jam over.
One, two.
Two count. And Chip is down. I tell you what, these U.S. Tag Team Champions, you can say a lot about them, but one thing is they are ruthless. They know how to get an opponent down and literally drive him to the mat. And I want to remind you, the Wrestling Hotline comes your way 24 hours a day. Join me each and every Monday with some late-breaking information about World Championship Wrestling. Each and every Monday, only on the Wrestling Hotline. We have a lot of fun with our trivia question as well. We're able to stump some of our fans. Speaking of fans, they're up on their feet now, trying to get behind Chip. Chip is up. Taylor down. Chip wanted to bring the wrong man in, and now he found his whereabouts. Top champion is fresh, but he has to watch out of being too overzealous here. He can't get into a fight with both men, but he's got Taylor now to a neutral corner. The old count with the fans to 10 trick. And on the outside. All those blows heavy on the side of the head of Taylor. But Champion dumped on the outside. Taylor sees it. And Champion may not have hit as squarely as he wanted to. Chip going after Valentine. Todd got his spinning elbow. Hammer got his elbow in the back of the neck. We have a winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, the team of the Tailor-Made Man and Greg Valentine.
So the U.S. Tag Team Champs prevail once again. Once again, let's take a look at some of the action. Vertical suplex, one of the great moves that Valentine employs. And then after the spinning elbow from Todd Champion, the referee moving Chip back, here came the big clubbing elbow from Greg Valentine. Valentine and Taylor win again. An extended version of the WNN when we come back on Worldwide.
You know, there's one type of man that could look at his face in the mirror and be proud of it. It's a real man. Real men don't use steroids because we're tough, for real. You know, steroids can lead to cancer, they can lead to sterility, and you could be laying up in hospital for months watching your tendons rip away from the bone. So don't be a jerk, or you'll never be at the top of your sport for 17 glorious years.
Of the Wrestling News Network. I'm Eric Bischoff. 2 weeks ago, ravishing Rick Rude successfully defended his United States heavyweight title at Super Brawl 2 against Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. However, as always with the Dangerous Alliance, even though Paulie dangerously was barred from ringside, They had a plan. A plan which apparently began when Missy Hyatt was trying to convince the ninja to let her see Steamboat for an interview. And then Medusa arrived.
You go!
Okay, how about some sushi? You and me, sushi.
Sushi.
Sorry.
You go! You go!
Nihongo.
Go!
Nihongo, wakata?
No!
I didn't think so. English, comprende?
No.
Good, good, good. Okay, now, let me see Ricky Steamboat.
No, Steamboat! You go!
Let me see Ricky Steamboat.
No!
I want to see Ricky Steamboat now. Now, I want to see Ricky Steamboat now. God! Woo! Oh, my gosh! What?
Oh! Now, no one really knows what happened after Medusa and the ninja left the locker room area. But interestingly enough, after the next match, the ninja was back, ready to accompany Steamboat to the ring.
I'm so excited about this match. Oh my gosh, and there he is. He looks like he is really prepared for this match. Oh my, and there goes Ricky Steamboat. This is going to be the best U.S. title match ever.
Now, Steamboat and the Ninja were on their way to the ring for the match against Root. Now remember, Paul E. Dangerously was barred from ringside in this match. In what was one of the most intense battles of the night, ravishing Rick Rude and Ricky the Dragon Steamboat gave it their all. But then something happened. The Ninja, the man protecting Steamboat from outside attacks, turned on the Dragon. Here's what happened.
It's all Steamboat now! Oh!
To becoming the next United States heavyweight champion.
Well, Steamboat has definitely got his second wind. He's going up to the top. High risk maneuver. Rude doesn't know where he's at.
Oh. To the top. Steamboat's got to go in his way. And then Paul E. Dangerously is going crazy back and forth.
He should cover him. Why is he going up again? He should cover him.
The blow with a telephone ended Ricky Steamboat's chances for winning the WCW United States Heavyweight Championship. By using the telephone as a weapon, it was apparent to many that the ninja was, in reality, Paul E. Dangerously. However, it wasn't until after the match, as Missy Hyatt was attempting to do an interview with Ravishing Rick Rude, that our assumptions were confirmed. Take a look at this footage and see what happens inside Ravishing Rick Rude's locker room.
There was so much controversy surrounding the U.S. title match, and Rick Rude is still the champion. I don't know what happened to the ninja. It's just like he went crazy or something. But let's try to get an interview with the champion, Rick Rude. And here's his dressing room. And over there, oh, my God! Oh, my gosh! That was Paul E. Dangerously, and he was in a ninja outfit!
The video you just saw tells an incredible story, one all too familiar to Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. He's standing by with his comments.
You know something, ladies and gentlemen? Weeks prior to one of the biggest matches in my wrestling career, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat took the precautions. I had thought that I had covered all the bases. I had my ninja. Week in and week in on out, people on television saw my ninja covering my back. I thought I had Paul E. Dangerously covered along with the Dangerous Alliance. But in my wrestling career, I've got to say that the Dangerous Alliance was one step ahead of me and outsmarted the Dragon. But let it be said that in my quest to be the United States heavyweight champion, be the last thing that I ever do in my wrestling career. I've been down that long road many times, and I've been beaten down, down, down many times. If this is the final chapter, let it be written, Rick Rude. This is a warning to you. This is directed to you. And anything that I do for the rest of my wrestling career, as long or as short as it may be, I'm going to get the United States Heavyweight Championship belt.
Those comments from Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Was it Paul E. Dangerously dressed up as a ninja? Well, the video seems to prove that point, and it seems to point toward the fact that when Medusa was chased by the ninja, that somehow the Dangerous Alliance was able to make the switch. What we do know for sure, however, is that the Dangerous Alliance, led by Paul E. Dangerously, always seems to have a plan. Just when you think you've prevented Dangerously from another underhanded trick, he strikes again. It's a matter that needs to be reviewed by the WCW Board of Directors. I'm Eric Bischoff, and this has been the Wrestling News Network.
Okay, fans, welcome back to Worldwide. And don't forget, still to come after the break, we will have our main event. The Steiners, Rick and Scott Steiner, as you know, after those World Tag Team belts, will face one half of the World Tag Team champions, Beautiful Bobby, and the Cruncher, Larry Zbyszko. But what about the footage we've just seen from Super Brawl? Paulie Dangerously, apparently dressed up as the Ninja, knocking out Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, helping Ravishing Rick Rude retain the U.S. Heavyweight title. Paulie claims that was not him in the Ninja outfit. However, I think you saw the footage. It was very obvious. It was Paulie dressed up, knocking out Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. You know, we heard from Sting early on. Sting knows he's in the hot seat as the WCW World Heavyweight Champion. Before we go to the break, and before we go to our next main event right here on Worldwide, we have standing by Harley Race, the manager of Big Van Vader, and Big Van Vader himself with some comments as they had last week on the program directed towards the World Heavyweight Champion Sting. Let's go to that interview.
Sting, you have amazed the world. You even accomplished amazing me by winning the world's title not once, but two different times. But you haven't experienced what this man right here is capable of delivering. You have not taken this man very seriously. But I'll guarantee you, from this day forward, you're going to take this man more seriously than any human being that you've ever looked at. At any given point in time, when you walk in the ring, when you walk in the ring with this man right here, you're coming in to experience more pain, more suffering than anything that's ever happened to you since you stepped into a squared circle. Right here, the man, today.
Sting, the name of the game is pain. When Vader steps in the ring, that's it.
This is Jesse the Body Ventura coming at you from Hollywood, California. You know, life in Hollywood's great. I got my own dressing room. I love it. And something else I love is I'm just 4 weeks away from The Body Returns, World Championship Wrestling on Worldwide Wrestling. And I can't wait for it. I've been out of wrestling far, far too long. It's time, 4 weeks away, for The Body Returns. Let's go back now to World Championship Wrestling on Worldwide Wrestling.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, representing the Dangerous Alliance, and accompanied by the Chief Executive Officer, Paul E. Dangerously. First, from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, weighing 244 pounds, Larry the Cruncher Zbyszko. His partner from Huntsville, Alabama, 233 pounds, Beautiful Bobby.
You know, so many times Paulie is putting out these tests. You got to test yourself here, test yourself there before you get the real title shot. I guess there's another one of his tests.
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents from Detroit, Michigan, total combined weight 525 pounds, Rick Steiner, Scott Steiner, the Steiner Brothers.
They are standing. The bell is sounded, says Nick Patrick, and the fight is on. The Cruncher, Scott Steiner, Beautiful Bobby going at it with Rick Steiner. Frankensteiner! That's it!
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners in record-breaking time, the Steiner Brothers!
Well, I guess they passed the test. Can you believe it? And we've got a lot of time left here. Look at this. Frankensteiner less than 30 seconds into the match. The Steiner wins. I'm talking to Craig Leathers in the truck. Our director tells me, as you see the 1-2-3, that we are going to have a standby match. As the Steiners win, we'll have our standby match after WCW this week in this timeout.
Wow!
What a stunning turn of events in our main event here on Worldwide. Hello, everybody. I'm Eric Bischoff, along with the new look of the Freebirds, Jimmy Jam Garvin and Michael PSAs, and I understand, gentlemen, that you are getting impatient.
The fact is, this impatience isn't the word. I don't know how much longer we can remain calm, Michael Hayes.
Not long.
We've asked, we've kind of pleaded just a little bit, and we get no reaction. Well, the fact is this, somebody better do something soon, or they're going to regret the fact that they ever heard of the name the Fabulous Freebirds. And I'm talking about you, Terry Taylor, and you, Greg Valentine, and that United States Tag Team title that you're wearing around your waist. The best thing you guys can do, and I'm talking to you too, Arn Anderson and Bobby Eaton, is all of you get together, pull up in a car, come over to our crib, and drop the medal off at the doorstep, because one way or another, we're going to end up with it. That just might save you a few cuts and bruises.
See, boys, what we're having here is a real big failure to communicate. We come out to the ring, got our new duds on, we got a new song, everybody's rocking and grooving to the move.
Yeah.
What I want to ask you is, what is your excuse? What, are you afraid? Are you dodging a bullet? You're doggone right you're dodging a bullet. Just remember this. I can't say why we do what we do, but we're the Freebirds. And once again, what was your excuse?
We've never seen so much excitement here on Worldwide Wrestling. Ladies and gentlemen, it was a record for a win in tag team action. Let's bring them out one more time. Scott and Rick, the Steiner Brothers. I tell you what, guys, you know, I've never seen anything like this. And I know you're excited. Paulie's talking about the test, but you guys are after those World Tag Team belts.
I tell you what, Paulie, they see. You may have taken us the first time, but the next time, we're ready for whatever you throw at us. Bobby Eaton, Arn Anderson, we're just waiting. Do we come?
You know, I tell you what, Scotty, let me say this. We had that Frankensteiner on instant replay. I want you to take a look at it with us. It was an exciting move, really unexpected. We're talking about the Dangerous Alliance winning so quickly.
That's right, Paulie Dangerously. You send out beautiful Bobby and Larry Zbysko, but we don't want them. We want the best of the Dangerous Alliance. That means you, Arn Anderson, and Bobby Eaton. Next time we get you in the ring, you guys ain't gonna like it.
All right, the Steiner Brothers with a tremendous win. Next for all I know, the World Tag Team title.
Yes, we can't wait.
All right, the Steiner Brothers with a great win, Ben. Let's go back to the ring.
First from Marietta, Georgia, weighing 234 pounds, Marcus Alexander Bergwell. His opponent from Cheyenne, Wyoming, 277 pounds, Mike Thor.
All right. Fireworks off Worldwide. So good to have you with us, and quickly want to remind you, next week we hope to have information and some comments possibly from Nikita Koloff based on what we have seen at the top of the program and having a Super Brawl a couple of weeks ago. Marcus Alexander Bagwell, tell you what, we're still out of breath from that Steiner win. Steiners want to be World Tag Team Champions. We saw what happened at Super Brawl. And Paulie with his little games that he plays with many of these top athletes. And this time it backfired on him. The Steiners, as prepared as ever right now. Let I know, they have that match signed with beautiful Bobby and Arn Anderson for the World Tag Team belts. Let me say something also as you take a look at Bagwell about the cruncher Larry Zbysko. Every time something like this happens to him, someone gets hurt. Right now, Larry Zbysko may be the most dangerous man in the Dangerous Alliance. It's a man you certainly don't want to trust. And a man who loves more than winning matches. Winning's not important to him. What's important is hurting people. And Bagwell held on. Vance here completely, as I was, stunned by that quick win. And it was a record in World Championship Wrestling for the quickest tag team win ever. Right hand to the face, to the midsection. Irish whip, Bagwell hit steam. But the leg, and we get a two. Bagwell again. He and the Z-Man, we saw earlier on. Greg Valentine and Taylor Made Man, the U.S. Tag Champions. Well,
I was just notified by Craig, our director, Craig Leathers, again, that we understand that Paulie is really, if I can use this term, raising hell in the black dressing room area. I don't know what. I don't know if he's going to want to come up here and talk with me, or I got to stand up and do an interview or what here with him, but we do understand that there is some commotion being all perpetrated by Paul Lee in the back dressing room area. May, I don't know if we get a camera. We can. Right there? Maybe? Well, maybe next week. We're going to try. Maybe next week we'll have some comments from Paul Lee Dangerously on what it transpired. Right here on Worldwide Wrestling this week. It certainly has been one of our more exciting weeks. Bagwell, an abundance of wrestling talent, this young man right here. Over the top. Gore with a great move. He stopped him dead in his tracks that time. He wanted to do a hip toss out, but he just pushed him right down to the mat. Reversal. Bagwell in. And up with an arm bond. You know, it doesn't surprise me that Paul Lee is raising all the stink. It wouldn't surprise me that he's on his phone right now talking to K. Allen Fry, the WCW offices. Hopefully he doesn't have his home number. But every time something happens to Paul Lee, especially on television, someone hears about it. So I'm glad I'm not in the back right now. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Beautiful Bobby with a belt. Arn Anderson with a belt. The World Tag Team
Champion.
Well, he wants the Steiners. He's going to get the Steiners.